நான் பார்த்தது சபை ரெண்டாவது வீடு தோசி ரெண்டையும் நான் தினமும் கோவிலேஷ் பற்றி பார்த்தோம்னா ஒரு பெரிய பற்றியை உண்டுபடக்கூடிய ஒரு கண்டூர்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஏலி ஐஎன்ஹெச் ஆஃப் தமிழ்நாடு அவர்கள் சவுதி போகக்கூடிய அளவுக்கு நான் போயிருக்கின்றோம். ஏனென்றால் ராகவனை கூற வேண்டும் என்றால்
ரிப்போர்ட்ஸ் அந்த ஃபஸ்ட் ஆர்ச்சியாலஜி படிஸ் எல்லாம் ஒன்று தான். அண்ட் தென் தேர் இஸ்
the Australians started also. Throughout the world, he has traveled and he has published many, all international anthropologists.
Unfortunately, has not made much breakthrough on fossilized point I'm trying to say, but the evolving ancient DNA tracking, the problem is even the mummified bodies or fossilized forms in the same world, and the skeleton same, mummified body same.
Deconstruct, அந்த சமயத்தில் சிறருடைய ஃப்ரெண்டு ப்ரொஃபஸர்
Nepal, Ganga, plain, Mesolithic humans, 9,000 years old, Ganga, middle Ganga plain, skeletons, work money from it, and the complete skeletons. So I send him, please find out, they are 9,000 years old. Kindly find out, these skeletons belong to each race. Usually they charge $800 per hour, but he did it free. He took almost 3 days and sent to me a major compliment back to me. So we have written a volume on it. I request this man to get into the certificate to go through it once more. So in the Unniana, in the Aramanda, whether it's only a contemporary ancestors for a contemporary temples or where we are. In a standing in the Abhiman and Dalmayanapu or Tata Tantanayanapu, I should do it systematically and work. So, when you see the skeletal, what you call the primatologies, nearly the whole system is having 180 odd micro level measurements. Takes about almost 4 hours to measure one skull. Initially for me, but in the overall period of time, I did about 1700 human skulls I measured from different ethnic groups of India. My speed increased and I took only 22 minutes to measure one. But I spent more time with them because it's an archaeological specimen with a lot of cracks and missing parts. I studied about 85 human skeletons in the statistical analysis manually, then put them into software, send to my contemporaries there, and they agreed with my finding. Upon the finding of Andronam, I could find a lesser amount of contemporary Tamil people, and most of them are different ethnic groups belong to different races. But this is the archery that we have to go to make, because when you see a harbor city, you see the people coming from abroad for business purpose or just for any other visiting purpose. They usually might have preferred to stay at a place which is closer to the sea, might have that place probably would have been a metro cultural center, might have been in India with how many years atmosphere might have died and got buried. And few skeletons only we have seen some cut marks due to some disputes or conflicts. But most of the skeletons we found have a good amount of the skeletons, nearly 40% of the skeletons we found pathologically abnormal skeletons. So pathologically abnormal is basically a hereditary disease and malnutritional problems or affected by the environmental factors or work related stress and strain and the madri. But infectious disease also a good amount of skulls I could see, the sexually transmitted disease like syphilis, venereal disease, can easily recognize from the different features of the skull. Then I could manage to see some fetus also, 3 months, 2, 8 months, three of them we reported. Then most of the skeletons are single variant. Archaeology department said they are secondary variants, but no, 90% of them are primary variants because squatting position and squat variant, it is not possible for a secondary variant. Once they die in certain that position to be taken, or they might have died while sitting in that position in that giant. But there are few secondary barriers, but the thing is they are. The entire skeletons were preserved in good amount of number, but in some preservation we could not see the complete skeletons. He could see some parts are missing. Some parts are missing in the sense hand is missing or wrist bones are missing, leg bones are missing. But he could see in that particular plane funeral ashes, burnt ashes, probably a customs might have occurred. Part of the body might have been cut and burnt and they might have put it in small dabbas or whatever, I mean, clay might have been buried there. Then he could find some grains and some seeds, you know, from some silk cloths and some metal implements, some of them. Then I am the Tamara Parani, southern, this is on the right side of the river, isn't it? Why did a surface study for a 2-3 days completely? Collected good amount of samples from, basically I am having a very strong background in paleontology and geology because my PhD is based on geology of Southern Himalayas. So that made me a lot to collect the samples and identify, recognize the rocks and soil samples. Then fossils also, I got some semi-fossilized ones, then some recently buried in 2,000-3,000 years old samples. So I could see on the upper Adichanallur and the Tamil Nadu river distance for 20 kilometers per month.
Okay.
So, but that time the sea would have been inside because I found some fish which belongs to the marine fauna. Now the cuttle mean, in until cuttle mean for a the polypora, other than the tower and the villanger and the and the Ramalampa now is dried up area. Probably the sea might have been there 4-5 kilometers inside. Might have dried in the time passage. Otherwise, shell pieces, shells, egg shells. Then I put it into the scanning electron microscope. And what amazing results, I immediately met my professor in Lucknow, Professor Ashok Sani. Recognizes you got a good almost a lottery ticket. For academician only these discoveries are lottery, not cash. You know, the shells belong to ostrich, which is not an indigenous species of India. Ostrich Tamil name is called Tikoli.
Nerpukoli.
Ostrich farms are there. Nowadays in Sri Lanka and Indonesia is coming up. But this might have been brought along with the sailors. And certain fish species are not found in India. We can recognize from the scale and the jaws and the teeth. So probably a center for domestication of certain animals for cultural beliefs or maybe for consuming purpose. So that was another cracking point of this investigation. Adhukapram, I went on to study the dental anthropological aspects. Almost 1800 isolated teeth plus many jaws, maxilla, upper and lower jaws, with teeth, without teeth, in complete skulls. Skull means cranium and mandible. Investigation part. Dental anthropological investigation, you can always find that, find out racial differences from the dentition. You can see from which area this person belongs to. Then certain enamel pieces which I got, I put the scanning electron microscopic investigation. From the enamel or from the teeth, there are two things. One from the enamel. Enamel one is the hardest part of the human body. The hardest material is found in the world is diamond, that is 14. This comes about 8. But now they have artificially made one diamond which is much harder than the original one. Diamond is what is made out of carbon monoxide. இது வந்து உங்களுக்கு என்ன அவங்க சிறப்பு இந்த ஹார்டஸ்ட் பார்ட் இந்த பாடி எனிதிங் கெட் டிஸ்இன்டிகிரேட் கெட் டிகேட் பட் நார்மல் வில் ரிமைன் தட்ஸ் வை இன் பாலியோலஜி மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் த டைம் வி கெட் டீ அண்ட் போன்ஸ் ரெஸ்ட் ஆஃப் த பார்ட் கெட் டீகம்போஸ் வெரி குயிக்லி அந்த எனாமல் பீசஸ்ல இன்வெஸ்டிகேஷன் பண்ணி பார்த்தா ஹியூமன் எனாமல்
such kind of pathologically abnormal skeleton anywhere in the
not only me, most of the anatomists all over the world, they are used to see yet to read the paper. Because whatever I write, I usually make sure should not be having criticism. Criticism is something my weak point I cannot stand. So, I have to acknowledge that too. Abhipraya Vedangale in our Tamil Muria. My sister always says, no, you should accept that. Engineer was given by an outcome. But why I tell you, you see, this telegraph, you see, this is the eye socket, right eye, this is the left eye socket, and this is the people all this to, including an anatomist, Professor J. Raj, is an eye socket, it's not an eye socket. This is a tumor. Yeah, internally I have done the scanning, I got nothing but lot of blood capillary trace marks here. I will tell you, I will come to that point later. And yeah, here is the abnormal skull. This is the right eye, this is the left eye, and this is the tumor. This is called Professor. So, outstanding professor of physical anthropology, and he won many awards. He teaches at the University of Harvard. And I sent him, he sent it within a week time. This is called 40 is Puff Human. 40 is the man who named his human. And one more thing, you see, this is the right eye, this is the left eye, this is the humerus socket. And you see this. This is the nasal bone. உங்களுடைய மூக்கு போன பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ரெண்டு வேஃபர் திக்னஸ் தின் போன்ஸ் இருக்கும். அதெல்லாம் இந்த பாக்ஸிங்கில் ஒரு பையனோட பக்கத்து ரத்தமாக போட்டிருக்கோம். இந்த வருஷத்துக்கு அப்படியே நடந்திருக்காரு. ஏனென்றால் ஹி ஹேட் ஒன்லி ஒன் சிங்கிள் திக் நேசல் போன் வித் வெல் மார்க் மார்க்கெட்.
Make it closer to the...
Yeah. You can see the nasal bone is very thin. Single bone with well-defined outer margin. And very strong. Even after 2,500 years, you cannot crack it. So imagine that man, it was very protective. And with all this kind of abnormality, this man lived beyond 65 years. Like our politicians. Yeah, my dad had a only thing which I made a mistake, I mean not my mistake. See, when they dig up the skeleton, it was complete. When I saw in the laboratory, it was broken. Had it been complete, I would have defined which ethnic group this man belonged to, which country, because I could make only one or two measurements. If I would have used that sharp edge instruments, I would have cracked the skulls further. So I never touched that part because more important to preserve this skull. We can make up millions of dollars in the world market. In the anatomy, usually they can buy it. It's the biggest custody now. So you can see these are the crack ones they have cracked it. And here you can see very clear this socket. This is the humerus. This is the eye socket left, this is the right. And you see, this is elongated, well defined, single nasal bone. And the skull is thick but not extraordinary thick. I have seen there are some many skulls here having very, very thick, strong calcified. Because the extraordinary thickening of skull also is a disease. Anything is extra is a disease here. And when you see, this is a radiological photograph. See, you know, we have two frontal sinuses, one on the right and one on the left. And this left sinuses is divided into branches. Here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here is 1, 2. And then this one, the tumor occurred within the sinus part only. Because this man had multiple frontal sinuses, or you can call it branch sinus sinuses here. And another very important thing, you see in the frontal septum, which divides the cranium, very sharp, very thick, very the height also very deep. So this we have done the scanning, and you can see the thing more clearly. And here, this is the tumor part, and this is next to the tumor, and this is the left sinus part here. You see the branches, and these are doctors from Bharat scans, and they call us midnight one o'clock because they said we may not get any patients if you bring such kind of material. So he was just telling that this is seen for the first time in his life here. Because people usually ask me, when you work with the dead people, skeletons, are you not scared? I said, living people are more dangerous than the dead ones. And this is the reconstructed skeleton. And this tumor condition, you can see in this skeleton is also not well developed, but it's started here. This is on the left side. But you may think it's a genetically inherited. No. They are not related to each other. They belong to different ethnic groups, different races. Then how come this puff tumor, you may ask? Puff tumor condition is found deep sea divers, sailors, those who frequently go for diving in the sea. That is one of the reasons, plus some imbalanced diet condition also, like of minerals and vitamins. And this is one of the skull which I have noticed a lot of blood stains. This craniocephalus is a disease. Before the closure of the sutures, before the time it closes fast, so as a result the capillary start bleeding. That condition I could observe in this particular specimen. Here puff tumor condition observed in skull number 69 also, both the sides. And this is the result of the four disc analysis. For example, we have a battery of measurements, say nearly 40 or 60 odd measurements I picked it. Although 120 I took 60. But then the computer program only take about 18 measurements, and we compare it with different ethnic groups, many age ethnic groups and different races. In this, for example, this is the specimen number here. Number Adichanallur 81 skull, which is more closer to the black male of East Africa. This is the result here. And this is the four disc analysis, and you can see this is the most closer to the particular ethnic group or race, you can call it. And then this is skull number 13. Which is very closer to male Vietnam. VM means Vietnam male. And this is very closer to the American male, AMAM. American means basically about psychology. That time America was not found. And this is a white female. They could make it only till the racial level. The white female. This is the result here. And this is the retinal fragments, complete jaws, incomplete jaws, which we could find in the craniums. And these are the isolated jaws. And you see, when dental anthropology is concerned, we take how many varieties of teeth we have? Four. Incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. So, incisors and canines are single root. In certain places, certain ethnic groups, the premolar petroglyphics. The first polar arm, when there is a special paper, you press and take the impression, put it into the scanning electron microscope. Then we have the dermatoglyphics, the hand imprints. It gives the same imprints in the teeth. That is more reliable than this one. But it is not started yet. It is not used in India. But if you say it to your politicians, then all of them will be running to your house to take the impression. But it is not successful before 18 years or something. It's an age limit, you see. I had to go through that paper. The Russian technology. But it's very effective, I was told, for personal identification, the odontographics part. It's developed by the Russians recently. Yeah, these are isolated teeth. And these are the bones of backbones and other long bones, parts of the brain. Here are the various growth stages of the recovered specimens. We have fetuses, we have juveniles, we have adolescents, we have adult, we have stans. So, surprisingly, the most of the Adichanallur individuals of the society or societies, they lived beyond 55 years. Compared to that time, with the medical facilities, it's pretty amazing. And this sir might have explained you better because that is his field. And this is the outer surface of the one of the giant clay. We illustrate a new female and sugarcane and running deer and black buck. This may be a reptile. Might have been shown the prosperity because sugarcane is almost in harvesting time and grown up female probably might have shown the fertility of reflect the fertility and prosperity of the area. These are the different things. Yeah, this is the dental anthropology aspects exclusively on not mainly skeletal biology and dental anthropology, this investigation. And these are the different features of the skull. For example, sagittal keeling means roofing of the cranium, whether it's flat or round or pointed or sub-pointed, then this is the tendency is strong, medium, and all these things which play here. And the next is the bronchial bone, that is this bone, the shape, size, and the architecture of that. Then upper margin, orbital margin means this one, whether it's strong or it's light or sharp, everything, they have a different scale for that. According to that, you have to do the marking. Then inferior, the lower margin of the eye socket. Then frontal prognathism means the projection of the face. Some people have a projection of the face is basically the projection of the maxilla. And next is the zygomaxillary part. So these are different characteristics we have to take into our mind and compile this data. And these are the different features of the tusks, I mean the working form of the different teeth. And the recovered jaw is about 145, and these are the recovered number of investigators, different kind of teeth we have put over and upper jaw. And the number of incisors, upper and lower and canines, all this here. And these are the metric measurements, is all. And here is a racial diversity we can make from the incisors, how they are made. Shovel shell in a terribly form. M1 is one of the most important tooth for racial identification. M1 means molar one. First molar is more important than the other molar. The third molar first and the second, but basically the whole intent is with the first one. And aging by lending transparency, I told you when we see the outer surface is enamel, inner is dentine, then inside is pulp. So the dentine transparency, it goes by the age. The transparency, you know, focus in the time has aged. And these are the percentage of the interval growth stages of the skeletons. How many percentage of eaters, newly born, the juveniles, adolescents, young adults, adults, and over 60 years. And estimating the age from tooth we are, I will show you here. So you can see we are in the Adichanallur, this is the line between, when you compare it to the other world population, you can see there are different dental parameters and geographical zone I have taken into consideration these ones here. Yes. This is the aging by transparency. You can calculate the aging by using the spectroscopic microscope and mathematical calculation, and according to the years here and the years and the transparency of the age. Functional age, mechanism of the jaw, meaningful target and mechanism of the body, age calculation. And this is a figure which shows the overall bear body, and how much percentage bearing took place in molars, very according to the age and the type of food intake. Yeah. This is an anthropology of the state. This is the aging. And the mechanism of the jaw is a perceptional view from the top to bottom. And these are different features of the human skull of different races, mainly on races, how they look like. Yes. Thank you, sir. Any other
questions? Nereya kelvigal irukku. Can you summarize your conclusions in the sense that என்ன இதுல நீங்க சொல்றதுல இருந்து பார்த்தா இந்த இடத்துல இல்ல நீங்க மைக் வச்சுக்கங்க நீங்க வச்சுட்டு பேசினாதான்
மைக் வச்சுக்கங்க நீங்களும் மைக் வச்சுக்கோங்க இல்ல நான் அப்படி என்னுடைய குரல் எல்லாருக்கும் கேட்கும்
தரேன் மைக் இருந்தா பெட்டர்
பெட்டர் எக்கோ பண்ணாத
இல்ல 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 எக்கோ பண்ணல
நான் சொல்றேன்
இல்ல இப்ப நான் கேக்குறது வந்து நீங்க இங்க சொல்றதுல இருந்து அங்க
என்ன
சொல்றேன்
We have 169 acres. Roughly, how many acres you have dig? How much percentage we have done? 10%. So 90% of the excavation is still left. எலெக்ஷன் ரிசல்ட்ஸ் மாதிரி இல்லை ஒரே மாதிரி வந்துட்டு இருக்காது ஒரு இடத்துல டீல் பண்ணலாம் அந்த இடத்துல அப்படி இருக்கலாம் பட் ஒன் அமேசிங் ஃபேக்ட் வந்து த கண்டெம்பரரி டெமல் பாப்புலேஷன் ஆர் மிக்ஸ் ரேட் பாப்புலேஷன் இஸ் கம்பேரிட்டிவ்லி லெஸ் இன் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் டு த அதர் ரிசர்ச் அண்ட் எண்டமிக் குரூப்ஸ் விச் வி ஃபார்ம் இப்போ அதுல இருந்து ஒன்று தெரியுது இது வந்து ஒரு உபர் கடல் உரம் பண்ணினா அதாவது அதுவரையும் கப்பல் வந்திருக்காது கப்பல் வந்து கொட்டைகள் பக்கத்தில் இருக்கும் அது
வந்து
the shells which you found. The shells are only for the seashore. That's what the geology is
there are plenty of fish.
Plenty of corals I found. Plenty of sea fish also I found.
I found a picture of the saline water fish as well as the fresh water one. Fresh water would have been from the ponds, might have been eatable one, even sea water. Adhe madri, maybe we say Calcutta, but sea is pretty far from the city. Idhu adhe madri, andha madri far aayilla, maybe sir sonna madri, porkekkum indha city ku madrila ulla
sir.
நாலு எத்னிக் குரூப் சொன்னீங்க இல்லையா?
நாலு எத்னிக் குரூப் டிஃபரண்ட் ரேஸ் டிஃபரண்ட். ஒன் ரேஸ் கேன் காம்போசிட் ஆஃப் தௌசண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் எத்னிக் குரூப்.
ஓகே. நாலு ரேஸ். நாலு ரேஸ்ல எந்த ரேஸ் அதிகமாக இருந்தது அந்த இடத்துல?
காக்கசைட் மோ. தி ஒயிட் ரேஸ் மோ. மெடிட்டரேனியன் கோ ஸ்பானிஷ் அண்ட் இத்தாலியன்.
அப்ப வேர் ஆர் தி இந்தியன்ஸ் ஃபாலோயிங் இன் திஸ்? தே ஆர் கன்சிடர்ட்
Indians don't have a racial identity. They stand in between all.
Okay.
That is the conclusion. The South Asia, basically Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, and some parts of Nepal, we don't clearly call towards any racial identity, although we carry at least 2 to 3 race genes with us. But not the frequency of calling towards a particular race is not there. And I cannot call we are an ethnician. Why can't we say the race is originated from us?
Yeah?
Isn't it? But people say from Europe, Aryan invention and all, I don't believe that. This something we say we have there is a scientific thing. But then Peter Belwood told me, you are correct, when you see the intensity of changing the Mongolite from Darjeeling to Japan, the youngest race I call you the Mongolite race, the fossil also, the youngest Mongolite fossil is only 14,000 years in South Japan. This Negroid race we found almost 500,000 years ago, but then they say Neanderthal man is the ancestor of Caucasite, but that is also not Neanderthal man about many species. The last species doesn't have much abilities with the modern Homo sapiens. Adhemadna, people say the Homo erectus is the ancestor of Homo sapiens. To an extent, there is a diversion takes place, but when, how many genes were split before? Answer.
Yeah.
culture. It cannot be older. That is the my senior professor Peter Bellman is explaining.
Exactly.
This is about 2500 years. But we may get an older strata. I am not sure, but we get to strength at point. But I prefer to have a, since it's an organic material, prefer to have a carbon dating.
But
it can help.
But first time you have a study that they need the race of the people and before that, only the anatomical report.
Even in the 2000 and the mother material is covered, just by comparing the material culturally or tell that they have done the dating.
And then?
Carbon dating.
Not carbon dating. It is anatomical quality, medical quality, and they are good at
both. They
are good at both.
Architecture, which can give you the basis of skeletal biology or even anthropometry, we group them into four races. Many people don't believe in races for political reasons, but races are there. But again, DNA, human DNA is common for all four races, but frequency of expression of certain traits differ. Fertility into certain races, according to the geographical zones. It does have the differences due to many factors, with environmental changes, hereditary and mutational stress and strain, many factors do alter. But when you say this particular person belongs to this particular race and this particular ethnic group, it's all standardized charts have been already made by many people, and reliability rate is pretty high. Not only now, the racial classification was initiated by Adolf Hitler during the Second World War, and he engineered the anthropometry. German people are number one in biological anthropology, particularly on forensic anthropology. He wants to eliminate the Jews from the rest of the Europeans, and he wants to keep the African out of human race. He calls them subhuman race, and he wants to identify the Jews out, and he was all out to have his views and his dreamland of Aryans. No scientific formula we can apply Aryans, Dravidians. This kind of things are only linguistic cultural evidence, not having any scientific case. And also when you see a country on borderlines, you have adulteration. Mixed marriages, civilized form I can tell is a mixed marriage. So we do carry different race, tribes and ethnic groups. Even people say the people from Kutch region entirely have a different appearance than the other people of nearby region.
What about the language?
But they might have had some kind of understanding, because making up a language is not a difficult thing for humans, because our brain is so developed. For most people, we pick up. We can not like the other language, but we can pick up the language for our own benefit. That's the way it is. But as I told you, one brain is composite of numerous ethnic groups. People say, I have seen a white man. A white woman is going on the road. I asked my professor colleagues, sir, that this girl is going there. You say she's an Australian or she's a Spanish, she's an Italian, she's a German. He looked at me and said, sorry, no. But Indians, to an extent, we can identify to an extent, not always. This person belongs to this geographical zone at least, or this ethnic requirement. But in white ways and ethnic units, it's very difficult to look at them and belong to Chitrin. But even in Mongolites, there's a problem. Australian police never enter the Chinese Indian territory because they cannot identify who's at home, because they all look alike. But the Japanese people, you can easily isolate from Chinese. They're a little bit darker than the Chinese people. In China also, down south, usually not only the texture has not, I mean, features may be same, but texture variation comes into the sunlight. But I'm not, we have to do more work on this area. We have to do a lot of work on this area. We have just less than 20% conclusion of anything. Not complete is not justified, but we are looking for some opportunities to come. Yes, sir.
Ostrich shell, ostrich, egg shell.
That bird might have been brought to India for domestication and consumption. Paper, And this is, Peter said it's about early Iron Age, 22 to 25 years. But then you see that the Jagna colonization by the Tamils about 1800 years ago. So probably this might be a continuous process of sea trade and human settlement all over the places. And I have seen Mark Oxen, my friend. He's a bioarchaeologist. He's working on, he said he has seen first century Lord Kartikeya temples in Vietnam and Cambodia and other places. And Iron Age disease, he's working on those skeletons. He only, whenever he gets these papers, he transmits to me through email. And he said that it's amazing, this kind of discoveries. It's second, third century. That's what he said. I have news for me, but this happened about 10 years ago. So I think Tamils might have penetrated up to Philippines, probably, to Southeast Asia. Even in Java, Sumatra, even Eastern Java, there is a lot of Hindus. It was Indonesia also.
Okay, later.
Late one, we have always said about this. So, but that's what we do, that there are tunnel loading, there are being there. You got any anchors?
Anchor like thing we got. That's by Alexandria. This is one of them.
So that itself is a difference.
ஒரு நாளைக்கு 10 ரூபாய் கூலி எனக்கு வந்து செய்ய கொடுத்தாங்க. அவர் பண்ணுங்க
பொழுது அங்க வந்து இந்த மாதிரியான அப்பயே வந்து ஸ்ரீலங்காவுக்கும் நமக்கும் வந்து நடந்திருக்கு அப்படிங்கிறது கிட்டத்தட்ட ஒரு 6000 இயர்ஸுக்கு முன்னாடியே அவங்கெல்லாம் கேட்டுருக்காங்க. இந்த மாதிரி இன்னும் வந்து பல பசல்ஸ் நம்முடைய தமிழ்நாட்டுடைய வரலாற்றுல பசல்ஸ் இருக்கு. இன்னும் வந்து ஒரு தீர்மானமாக இதை சொல்ல முடியவில்லை. ஆனால் திரு ராகவன் அவர்கள் போன்றவர்கள் ராகவன் அவர்கள் போன்றவர்கள் இதை வந்து சயின்டிஃபிக்காக அதை ஆராய்ச்சி செய்து அவர்களை வந்து அழைத்திருக்கிறார்கள். அது தமிழ்நாட்டு வரலாற்றுக்கு ஒரு முக்கியமான ஒரு திருப்பம். ஏனென்றால் நாங்கள் கோவில் மட்டும் நாங்கள் பண்ணோம், அது வந்து எல்லாமே கிடைச்சது. இதே மாதிரி லோன்ஸ் கிடைச்சது, ஏழு பள்ளிகளுக்குள்ள கிடைச்சது, அதெல்லாம் நாங்கள் வந்து அகாடமி வச்சு நாங்கள்லாம் பண்ணோம். அதே போல் குடும்பம் இப்போ வந்து கமலிடம் வசதி பண்ணிருக்காங்க. பல இடங்களில் தமிழ்நாட்டில் நீங்கள் போய் எங்கு இருந்தாலும் தோன்றினாலும் இந்த ஆண் பெரியஸ் உள்ளார போன்ஸ் எல்லாமே கிடைக்குது, செல்ஸ் கிடைக்குது, எல்லாமே இருக்கு. சில இடங்களில் கத்தி வச்சுருக்காங்க. வீட்டை காலத்து குடும்பங்களில் நாங்கள் பண்ணும் பொழுது அந்த வரியில் பக்கத்திலே பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஒரு கத்தி ஒரு ஒன்றுல ரெண்டு மூன்று ஸ்கோர்ஸ் இருக்கு. அது மாதிரி பல இடங்களில்